Hello, this video will show how to accurately measure and cut a violin sound pulse using KNKS VSP series tools. Equipment needed: a saw, cutting block. The cutting block has marks to show a line where the sound pulse should be held for cutting. Also use a handheld saw guide. We will use Model VSP Pro 2 Plus sound post inserter. It includes handle extension arm that can be lowered to point to the sound post position. For measuring, we can use Model VSP G3 or VSP G3 Pro sound post gauge. The sound post gauge construction uses a rigid tube and sliding piston, so when expanded and placed in a restricted area, the gauge contracts to assume new size. The end of the body has a ball and it will accept a swivel cap. When pushed against any surface, the swivel cap will assume the angle of contact. Here we also need masking tape, scissors, a ruler, and a pencil or pen. Now we can start with that. We put masking tape, prepare the base, draw a line, let's align the sound to the gauge. About 1 inch from the middle, make a mark which will indicate the one end of the sound. So this is done. Now the next thing, we have to prepare the violin. We place a mark where the sound post gauge is located under the bridge. The next thing to do, because we use the bridge, we just loosen the string and move the E string out of the way. Insert the sample here. Set it in the right place. This time, we make a little mark at the bottom of the gauge to show the position where the sound pulse should be inside the violin. It's at the back of the violin. Then we begin. Now the gauge has assumed length of the sound post in that area. What we do is assume the sound post, measure it, apply it to the between the two points, and make a mark to show you where the gauge is. This will give you this. At this time, we just mark each end, bottom, which is back, and top, which is the belly, so that we don't confuse, because the angle on the sound post could be different on both sides. Okay, now is the time to start measuring the angle. We set in the gauge with the ball pointing downwards, that means towards the back of the violin. We'll put a swivel cap on it. There it is. Now with this swivel cap on.
The swivel cap. And again.
Put the swivel cap. Insert it into the violin. Sound box. place it in exactly the right place, right spot. Push down on the tool to make sure it gets good contact, then push up to shorten the gauge.
There it is. That's it.
This gauge now assumes the angle of the sample that should be at the back of the violin. Align carefully along the line, align the sound post, make two marks shown by the plane key that is attached to the key, very, very useful, and this shows where it goes. We'll use a ruler. Draw a line running right across the end of the center line. The angle is measured. Now we have to do the same thing. We reverse the sample gauge so that the ball is on the top. Align the insert the tool, push the sample gauge up to make sure the swivel is aligned with the top. Carefully pull it out, and there it is, that's the other side of it. Now we basically do the same thing with the belly of the violin. You just put it in place, make some marks, or alternatively we put a ruler right close to the marking plate of the sound post and just mark a line. And here it is. Now we know how to do the sound post. Now we have to prepare the sound post. We do make a mark. Remember that the grain should be perpendicular to the grain of the violin. This would be the bottom part. That's where the mark is. Mark shows where the bottom is, and that would be the shortest end of the sound post. All we need now is just put the saw guide in and start sawing. Hold the sawmill and start cutting. Well, this one end is done. Now we do the other end. The job is done. You need to make clean out the edges. Now in fact, you can put the sound post back in, exactly in the right place, just as it was cut. Push in. Now it stays in the frame. And what we need to do is just move the strings back where it was, and then tighten up the strings a little bit so the sound post doesn't fall out. Now it's all firmly. And now, let's see. Okay, that's tight enough. Now we can remove the sound post too. And there it is, the work is done. Well, thank you for watching it. Here is the website.